'Twas the night before holiday break, and all through the halls, not a student was lurking, not even in bathroom stalls. The assignments were posted on classroom with ease, in hopes that Dr. Morgan would soon let us leave. All the students were sleeping all snug on their desks, hoping for good grades on all of their tests. With Camp in his office and Wavy in his tank, fresh new water with Jonah to thank. When out on Ritzer arose such a clatter, we sprang from our desks to see what's the matter. In a second, over to the window we had flown, the teacher did not even look up from his phone. We wiped all the fog off of the glass to reveal the fresh frost laid out on the grass. When what to our wondering eyes did appear, the sorry old cougar dressed up in snow gear. He approached the doors with gifts in his hands. Maybe he was sorry, here to make amends. Up to the door he knocked and he rang. Inside the rooms we heard a big bang. The door opened and he walked in with fear towards the B-Wing Film Studio to bring holiday cheer. Around the corner and down the hall, he gave presents and candy and happiness to all. As he neared the big doors, he began to worry. Would they all still be filled with sadness and fury? Before he entered, he saw through the window, the people, the food, the lights all aglow. A holiday party, he yelled with delight. This was his chance. His window was tight. But as he walked through the door, he was shocked to see a circle of grief all around the tree. As he walked in, they all looked up and cried, "There he is, the murderer, the reason she died." "Wait," one said, "let's hear him out to know why he's here." "I do me no harm," the cougar sobbed, "just here to give presents and spread holiday cheer." The students all discussed and then let him in because the season was about forgiveness, which made the cougar grin.